Okay, now that you understand the 60% of the 40-60 split, we're going to talk about the 40%. Here's the reality. The reality is you came into this business because you want to generate some income for your family or for your life. If somebody had told you that you're going to sell Mary Kay and you're going to make no money, you wouldn't have signed up for that. So I know and you know that you want to take a reasonable amount of money home from your business. Now, that is not going to happen automatically. That's a big misunderstanding, and it unfortunately happens too often because people don't watch over the numbers of their business. So I'm going to help you understand what the 40% of the 60-40 split really is and what your options and your choices are with it. Okay, so we talked already that 60% of the dollars that your business brings in gets budgeted for replacing the inventory that you sold, as well as making sure that you have sufficient income to buy samples and sales aids, as well as enroll your customers in the preferred customer program. So you can watch, if you don't understand the 60%, then you should go back and watch the previous video. But now we're going to be talking about the 40% over here. Now, the 40% is gross profit. Now, let's talk about what gross profit is. Gross profit is a big pile of profit, so to speak. It means that all of your business expenses, the 60% here, has already been taken care of. And this pile, so to speak, is what you have left over. But I don't want you to think that that is the money that you get to take home to your family, because you're in business and you're going to have other business expenses that you may incur. Nay, case in point might be something like if you took a business loan to buy inventory at the beginning of your business. You will need to pay your business loan out of the 40% gross profit that your business has. Or if you make a decision to buy more inventory than you have today, if you decide that you want to kind of have a healthier, more robust inventory stock, then you might make a choice to take some of this 40% gross profit and move it over here and rebudget it for inventory. You might make that choice. You also might make that choice to buy business cards for your business. It's going to come out of this 40% gross profit. So it's important that you understand that your 40% is not your profit. It is your gross profit. And let me help you understand business basics 101, and that is this. Income minus expenses equals profit. Business School 101. Income minus expenses equals profit. So all those little business expenses that creep up out of nowhere for your business make a difference in what you actually take home to your family. And let me help you to see that if you are very diligent and you really watch over this 40% and you make intentional decisions with that 40%, then you will be very successful in taking a paycheck home to your family. If you fly by the seat of your pants financially and choose to make your business decisions off of what your bank balance is, this 40% is not going to be going home to your family. If you are flying by the seat of your pants and hoping that everything is going to work out, you're going to see very quickly that you're not going to reap the financial rewards that you want from your business. So while you didn't come into this business to become a good money manager, the reality of it is if you look at any successful retailer, you know something about them. You know that they are watching their expenses, and you are fully aware that they are looking to make sure they have product on their shelf to sell to their customers, because that revenue source is the source of all things good in business. And if you look at any business that's gone out of business in your city, it's pretty easy to deduct that their income minus their expenses was not on the positive side of things. So don't make the mistake of thinking that you're going to be the exception and hoping that if you just keep these 40-60 split numbers in your head, that it's all going to work out. It doesn't work that way in business, and it doesn't work that way in money. So what's the solution? The solution is intention. Be very intentional with what you do with this 40%. Don't let it automatically get invested back into inventory unless you've decided that that's what it's going to do, because it helps grow your business. Or don't let all this 40% accidentally slip away into Section 2 items, because that's not why you're in business. Intention matters. And if you are intentional about making a profit in this business, then you couldn't have picked a better business model. You have a product that sells, you have a business plan that's proven to work, you've got support and leadership all around you. This 40% is why you're in business. And this 40% is the thing that will make you successful if you are intentional with it.